but looks my way, calls my name. Seems to leave this troubled world behind. And if I'm feeling down and blue, but troubled by some foolish game, she always seems to make me change my mind. And I feel fine anytime she's around me now. She's around me now, almost all the time. And if I'm well, you can tell she's been with me now. She's been with me now quite a long, long time, and I feel fine.
James Taylor was a coincidence. I mean, James came to me through a mutual friend, Danny Korchmar, who's a guitar player and record producer in America. James decided to head to England, and Danny gave him my phone number. So James called me when he got here. He'd made a demo tape and called me and said, you know, I'm a friend of Danny's. He gave me your number. Can I come and see you? So he came over, played me his tape that evening, and I loved it, was most impressed by it. And essentially said, look, it so happens I've just started work at this brand new record label. Because I'd already made it clear that if I found somebody I loved, I would have the right to sign them. I wrote a memo, which we found just the other day, explaining that I'd found this singer-songwriter. I thought he was very good. Obviously, if all the Beatles had hated it, it would have been difficult, but they didn't. So I said, you know, you're signed. You know, come sign with the record label. And that's what happened. It was quite fast and quite simple.
She's around me now, almost all the time. And if I'm well, you can tell she's been with me now. She's been with me now, quite a long, long.
The songs for the first album were mostly the songs off the demo tape. Carolina in My Mind was not on the demo tape. He wrote that subsequently. During the time he was in London, he was staying at my flat. After he came over that evening, he didn't leave. Carolina in My Mind he wrote while on holiday in Ibiza and came back from a week's holiday and played me that song.
In my mind I'm gone to Carolina. Can't you see the sunshine? Now can't you just feel the moonshine? And ain't it just like a friend of mine to hit me from behind? Yes, I'm gone to Carolina in my mind. Karen, she's a silver sun. You best walk her away and watch it shine. Watch her watch the morning come. A silver tear appearing, now I'm crying, ain't I? I'm gone to Carolina in my mind. There ain't no doubt in no one's mind that love's the finest thing around. Whisper something soft and kind. And hey, babe, the sky's on fire, I'm dying, ain't I? I'm gone to Carolina in my mind.
Around that same time, Paul McCartney had phoned me up because he'd been phoned by Twiggy, who had been watching Opportunity Knocks with Huey Green. And Twiggy had called Paul and said, you must turn on your television, this girl is remarkable. She was watching Mary Hopkin.
To everything turn, turn, turn. There is a season, turn, turn, turn. And a time to every purpose under heaven. A time to be born, a time to die. A time to plant, a time to reap. A time to kill, a time.
Paul then said, we have to sign this girl. So Derek and myself were detailed to go to Wales and sign Mary Hopkin, which we did.
Time to every purpose under heaven.
When Paul signed Mary Hopkin, he already knew he wanted to produce the record. I knew the song he wanted to make the first single. So he had a plan in mind the day we signed it.
Those were the days, my friend. We'd fight and never lose, for we were young.
been to a nightclub and heard this duo, Gene and Francesca, sing this song, Those Were the Days, and had filed it away in his music genius memory. Turned out that the melody was some traditional Russian thing, but they'd written the words.
And the busy years went rushing by us. We lost our starry notions on the way. If by chance I'd see you in the tavern, we'd smile at one another and we'd say,
helped produce that record. There was a classical composer friend of mine who'd done the strings on James, who we used to do the orchestra parts on Those Were the Days as well.
That was Mary Hopkin.
Mal Evans, who was the Beatles' road manager, brought in the Ivies on tape to an A&R meeting. He played a couple of songs. He was very keen on it, and the general feeling was absolutely, you know, Mal feels strongly about it. He's probably right. So we signed them.
I'll make believe that I don't care. I'll tell my friends I love my life. I'm happy.
They had one minor hit in America with Maybe Tomorrow, which is a good song, actually. I remember it now. And then I think the general feeling was that maybe the Ivies was kind of a wimpy name. And Neil Aspinall, to the best of my recollection, suggested Badfinger as a new and groovier name, which they adopted.
No matter what you are, I will always.